Christian?
Are you Christian?
Anyone?
Why you the last time you told me I'm not? You remember the discussion with the lawyer?
Who submit himself to the will of God?
Go and sort out your personality. Go and sort out your personality and we look.
Was Abraham a Muslim?
Did you hear what I said?
Good.
Yeah, I did.
Simple question, yeah.
Do you put Abraham?
According to you, was Abraham Muslim?
I know, but hey, he could be a devil, man.
The one that you got in heaven.
He could be the devil. What's his name? What's his name?
Allah is the devil.
Huh?
Allah is the devil.
Good, no problem.
What are you saying, Zach?
What? Allah is the devil.
We're happy with
what
it.
Saying,
if you're going to heaven, we're going to hell. We accept.
Do you want me to show you Arabic Bible?
Are you,
and Allah is the God
because
of the Christianity.
He's the Father, Son, Holy Spirit in the Arabic Bible. In the Quran, he's not the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Now answer the question. Is Abraham a Muslim or not?
Okay. Let me ask you one question. The Bible, the Arabic Bible, is it the Bible accepted by the Christian and Arab or not?
Yeah, yeah, and it's the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. You don't believe in the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Simple as that.
The Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
You don't believe in that, yeah.
Why should I?
But the Arabic Bible believes in that.
Thank you.
I don't know if I believe you.
Okay, yeah. Abraham, was he a Muslim, yes or no?
Yes, he was a Muslim.
Yeah, can you
prove it? Can you show me?
Can you prove it?
Yahya, can you show me if Abraham was a Muslim, when did he say the Shahada?
Ezekiel.
Yahya. No. Let me give him the thing. That's why he's becoming like Paul. Paul was the biggest murderer in the time of Jesus. His name is not Paul. They changed it to change the history. His name is Saul. He was a Jew.
Yeah.
He was killing all the one who believed in Jesus. Oh, you don't know that? Today, you know, he can go out with this guy right now. He's got 27 books in Christianity. They believe in him. It's him who said, if you don't believe that Jesus is saying the resurrection, our preaching is vain and your faith is vain. Jesus never talked to you.
I would because Muhammad is
Jesus said to the rich man, you know, when the rich man, what do I do? What do I do to go to heaven?
As a good, would you say, so you confirm Abraham is a Muslim, would you say Abraham was a good Muslim?
Of course he was a good Muslim.
He was a good Muslim. Just a moment.
So, yesterday.
Where is it?
Wait. Yesterday, I like you so much. And the interview with the other guy on the live stream. You've been talking.
What happens yesterday stays yesterday. Today is another day.
With me,
let's talk on the topic.
You cannot hold your tongue back for 2 minutes.
There is nothing personal. God still loves you. God still cares for you. And my God gave his life for you. So, was Abraham good Muslim?
What we were talking about?
Was Abraham a good Muslim?
Yes. And that's why...
So what makes him good Muslim?
Okay. What makes him good Muslim? His obedience and the trust of Almighty God.
So if
that's why he become the friend of God according to the Bible.
Okay. So can Muslims be friend with God? Can Muslims be friend with God?
Of course.
While Muslims are only slave to Allah, that is the highest place you can get. Yet Abraham becomes friend of God.
What is the Quranic verse? So, okay. You can be friends.
According to the Bible. So, just a moment. I just need to understand. Remember, I am woman. I am deficient in mind. Okay. So, if Abraham is a good Muslim. Can you just show me where is it in the Quran or in the Bible? Actually, in the Bible, since Bible came before the Quran, where Abraham is having I got distracted. Daniel, can you take over this conversation? Sorry, I pass you to Daniel. Just take it. You are talking about if Abraham is Muslim.
Prove it. Show me where Abraham's a Muslim.
You want me to bring the
Bible?
Your Bible
verse.
Bible?
Yeah. which Bible verse shows that Abraham was a Muslim, or even a good Muslim, or even in the Quran? Cold, cold day. Paul, are you okay? Sorry, man. You got it, yeah? Do you have it? Yeah, yeah.
Let me find it because I'm not ready to the subject. I need to find it. I don't know if.
Okay, if you're not ready for the subject, we can talk about relevant subject.
Yeah, because.
We can talk about relevant subject. What happened on Friday? Usman Khan killed two people.
What happened on Friday?
Usman Khan killed two people. He was a Muslim on Friday, London Bridge. And by the way, I was there in London Bridge.
Good that you didn't. He didn't shoot you there.
Or no, he didn't have a gun. But what he did is Islamic. Did you know
that? This is what do you think? What you think?
No, this is what Surah 911 says. Surah 812, Surah 839, Surah 47, 4-6. And Surah 929. It's not me.
It's not you, yeah?
Yeah, that's what the Quran says. John, shall we talk about that? If you're not ready with
no,
this
no,
one?
I'm not ready to talk about...
violence in about, the Quran. what Usman Khan did is violent.
You know me, or you don't know me?
Your name is Yahya.
Yeah. You know that... I leave always a comment on DCCI.
Yeah, out of context comments. So
out of context.
Can we talk about Usman Khan?
I'm trying to find you about Abraham.
But you said you're not prepared for that. Let's go with Usman Khan.
Why you don't speak up little bit?
Sorry?
Why you don't speak up little bit so I can hear you?
Let us talk about Usman Khan. What happened on Friday?
I already say my opinion regarding
Usman.
My opinion, any extremist, Muslim or non-Muslim, who whatever goes and kill innocent people, he must sick in his mind. And he have nothing to do with Islam. Because Islam doesn't give you
Allah
the right.
Does Allah say that?
Islam doesn't give you the right to go and take
Islam gives
to
you
punish
the right.
Other with your head. There is law, and there is a proper way of dealing. He didn't attack a policeman, or he didn't attack any. He attacked
civilians.
Normal passerby,
okay.
Civilian. They didn't do anything, and he is a traitor for himself and for everyone.
So you think Allah is a traitor?
It has nothing to do with Allah.
Let me read the Quran, then.
Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't give the authority for somebody to go and kill somebody.
Okay, let me show you. Let me show you what Allah says.
No, you see it, but I don't need to see it. I'm telling you my opinion.
Let me read it for you. Let me read it for you. Two verses, yeah?
Oh.
Yeah, yeah. You give me your opinion without any reference, without any Quranic reference. I'm going to give you my opinion with Quranic reference.
Okay.
Yeah? Here it is. Two references.
As long as you're coming to this.
I'll let you speak. Okay. Let me read this. Surah 8, verses 60. And prepare against them whatever you are able of power and of steeds of war, by which you may terrify the enemy of Allah and your enemy and others beside them, whom you don't know, whom Allah knows.
I agree.
That's Surah 8, verse 60.
This is in case of fighting another people.
It doesn't say that.
It doesn't say that. No. You choose and pick up whatever you
like. And then Surah 911, let me read this for you. Indeed, Allah has purchased from the believers their lives and their properties,
yeah,
for that their paradise,
yeah,
will be theirs. They fight in the cause of Allah.
They fight exactly
so they
as
battle. Kill and yeah. They are killed.
When they say to fight in the way of Allah, that means on a battlefield.
It doesn't say
not
battlefield.
I'm walking down the street and I see somebody.
It doesn't say battlefield.
Listen.
It doesn't say that.
Listen.
Yeah, are you the tafsir?
Listen. when he's talking about fight on the way of Allah and a battlefield,
it show doesn't. Me, show me.
Listen. So that means, according to you, any Muslim walking anywhere, he can kill anybody, and he's
not
a Muslim as long as kill.
According to me, according to the Quran.
Does that mean you're interrupting Quran?
That's what the Quran says.
According your idiotic way, because Quran doesn't allow you to, you fight who fight you. You don't fight somebody coming with peace and passerby. And he is not in quarrel with you.
So if I am an unbeliever, what are you supposed to do to me?
Nothing.
Because what does the Quran say? If I'm an unbeliever, what does the Quran say to do to me? It says, this is what it says. It says, fight those who do not believe in Allah.
Okay.
It starts with saying, okay, fight those who do not believe.
Okay.
Believe.
Okay.
I do not believe in Allah and your messenger.
Okay.
I don't believe. That's what the Quran says.
Okay.
So what are you supposed to do to me today? I don't believe in Allah.
Surah Al-Isra say, Aminu aw la tu'minu. Believe or not believe, it's up to you. Because as long as the message being conveyed that Allah is the one to worship and they choose not to believe, it's not up to us to force people into it. There's no compulsion and religion.
So,
I cannot force you,
are you saying,
into my religion.
Are you, saying,
you have your religion, I have my religion.
Okay, so are you saying there's a contradiction in the Quran?
No, the Quran was revealed during 23 years.
Okay, what was the last chapter to be revealed? The event
was changed. In the beginning, the Prophet, peace upon him, was under siege for 10 years and they've been abused. Then they go, when they become authoritative and with the power, they fight to defend themselves. Because
that's not what it says here. It's not for defense. It says, fight those who do not believe in Allah.
I'm explaining to you. You want to take my explanation, you're most welcome.
Can you prove it from the Quran? Where it says, fight those who don't believe in Allah, prove from the Quran that it means self-defense. It's not self-defense. It says, fight those who do not believe in Allah. And in the last day, who do not consider unlawful what Allah and His Messenger have made unlawful, who do not adopt the religion of the truth, which is Islam, among the people of the scripture, which are Jews and Christians, until they pay the jizya and feel themselves subdued. Their crime is to pay the jizya. Oh, their crime, yes, sorry, yeah. The crime I have is I don't believe in Allah.
You don't believe in Allah, it's up to you.
But that's what the Quran says, fight them.
You, as I said,
fight them.
There was a battle.
This is not, Surah 929 has nothing to do with the battle, Yahya. No battle whatsoever. No one was fighting anybody. What are you trying to look for? I'm reading Surah 929. Can you go from Surah 929? Even Surah 911. Usman Khan, he believes he's in paradise now because he got killed in the cause of Allah.
Okay. Surah 18.
Surah 18. I don't know why you're not answering Surah 9.
Surah 18, verse 29. Read it.
I didn't say 18, I said 9.
فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. So whoever want to believe, let him believe. And whoever don't want to believe, let him not believe. But the promise from Allah.
Are you just reading one part of the Quran and say this is it? And you leave the rest part of the Quran?
No, we don't leave the...
Explain Surah 929 to me. What I read to you. Surah 929. 929. Surah Al-Tawbah, which is chapter 9, verses 29.
Okay.
And I have the tafsir for you as well, tafsir Ibn Abbas. Ibn Abbas, yeah, until you get, I'll read it. It says, yeah. Fight against such of those who have been given the scripture, the Jews and the Christians, because they don't believe in Allah or the last day, nor in the bliss of the paradise.
Okay.
And forbidden, let me finish, in the Torah, that which Allah had forbidden by his messenger, and follow not the religion of truth. Do not submit themselves to Allah through confession of Allah's divine oneness.
Okay.
Until they pay the jizya readily, standing from hand to hand, being brought low, abased. So my crime is because I don't believe in Allah. That's my crime.
Okay. You want me to just talk about...
No, you said this
29.
Is a battle. You said this is a battle.
Yes.
Verse 29 is not a battle. It has to do with my belief system.
Yeah. Have you started from the beginning of the surah, or you just pick up the way you like?
You can start from the beginning, yeah, and you'll come to the same conclusion.
No.
You will.
Okay.
Because the context of this is from verse 28,
okay,
all the way up to 33, not from verse 1. The context, the immediate context. Are you going to read from 1 to 29 now?
Chapter 9, verse number 4.
Verse number?
4.
Okay, you're going to embarrass yourself.
That's
3. 4 is there.
I'm reading 4. I'm talking...
4 is there.
Not going anywhere, like...
Sorry? Yeah, go and read it. No. Yeah. Please read it. Read 4 and 5, please. Please, yeah.
Does that make him sure? I'm happy to answer the Bible. I asked you one question about your Quran.
I'm waiting, Yaya. What's going on? Oh, you know what it says.
What it says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the believer, they have nothing to do with the unbeliever, and they give them 4 months into a peaceful period. Then if they are still fighting the Muslim,
no,
the Muslim can fight
it
back.
It doesn't say that. Why don't you read it? Why are you giving me your tafsir, Yaya? You're embarrassed, isn't it? Are you embarrassed?
No, I'm not embarrassed.
So why don't you read it then?
But
you said you were about to read it and you stopped.
I need to be sitting properly and reading properly.
Sir, it's a cold day. You can't be sitting down today.
Pick up verse
you have to
from
stand
here,
up.
Verse from here. And
no, but you want to read from verse 4.
Whatever I tell you, you're not going to be convinced because you're coming here with an agenda.
I will be convinced if you can peel out the verses and prove your case. Peel them out and prove your case. I'll peel them out for you and prove my case that Islam is a religion of war and violence against unbelievers.
It is against the
unbeliever. Yeah, I'm an unbeliever.
Who are fighting against the religion.
That's your addition.
No.
Where is it in the Quran?
The Quran, fight whoever fight you. That's what it teach me. And if the one who fight me, he inclined to peace, I have to incline to peace and be peaceful with him, as long as he's peaceful for me. But if he broke the treaty between us and attack me, it's my duty to defend myself and fight back.
Okay, that's not what Surah 9 says. You're talking about Surah 2, which has been abrogated by Surah 9. You're talking about Surah 2, Surah Baqarah. Abrogated by Surah 9. Now, Surah 9:29. Respond to that.
You will accuse me of lying, or deceiving, or twisting, and I just told you what the Quran teach. Whatever you want to take a verse and rely on it to make your point, I accept that, and I explain to you why.
But you didn't explain to me from the verse.
I said to you.
You went to Surah 2 that's been abrogated.
Yeah.
You're explaining Surah 9 with Surah 2, which abrogates it. Surah 9 abrogates Surah 2.
You know Quran, how many surah and Quran?
114?
No, 114.
That's but, what I said.
Yeah.
Okay.
But what I'm saying, the Quran is like almost 4,600 something ayah.
No, 6,236. So, but that's not the point here.
Fantastic.
The point here,
fantastic.
Okay, let's deal with one by one. Surah 9, 29.
No, you cannot deal by one. You're relying on only one verse.
No, I'm not relying.
And you just want
I'm relying,
to prove yourself.
I'm relying let on me the get totality
another,
of the Quran.
Let me get another... because
you're going back and forth without any answer. He comes back, no answer. He goes, no answer. Come on, Yaya. What Usman Khan did is horrible. Terrible. Terrible. What Usman Khan did on Friday was terrible.
Of course,
but Islam taught him to do that.
No, Islam doesn't teach you to go and kill other innocent people.
God will be saving Koma.
Yeah.
Shams is apparently telling humanity that what happened in London Bridge has nothing to do with Islam. Godwin is there. Do you want to...
Yalla, run. There? Run, you're not going to get anywhere with me.
No, come if you want to defend. Come.
No, I don't need to.
How are you doing?
A Muslim still be able to carry out righteous actions as long as the Muslim unjustly in Islam.
Shamsi, stop lying. Stop lying, Shamsi. Surah 911. Surah 911. Surah
929. Who are saying they have no problem for children
to be slaughtered alive. You have a problem with that? Why are you lying? Why are you lying, Shamsi? Why are you lying? Usman Khan, why did on Friday? Was that Islam or not? You have no answer. ISIS are Muslims. We're not Muslims. ISIS are Muslims. We are not Muslims.
Talking about killing the children.
Stop lying, Shamsi. Surah 929. Surah 911.
Shamsi.
Don't get angry, Shamsi.
The Quraysh captured one of his companions called Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman. And they told him, we will let you go free. On the condition you don't fight against us.
Why can you not answer, Shamsi?
Came to the message of Allah. He said, oh, message of Allah, I cannot fight alongside of you against the Arab pagans in a war because they have given them a promise. What the message of Allah said, not forget them, they are kafir, keep all of them. No, he said, keep your promise, do not fight.
So he contradicted Allah.
So he contradicted Allah, yeah? He goes against Allah. Muhammad goes against Allah. Is that what you're saying?
So he went against Allah.
Exactly. That's a good one. He went against Allah, yeah?
Yes.
Muhammad went against Allah.
Allah said in the Quran.
Is that what you're saying, Shamsi?
Shamsi.
Allah said in the Quran that if you are fighting in a war with the non-Muslims, or if a group of Muslims fighting in a war with the non-Muslims, bear in mind, those non-Muslims, you have a contract with them, you should not join the Muslims to fight against them, except if you go to the non-Muslim openly, say, I don't accept the contract anymore, I'm going to break it openly.
So what does Surah 929 do with this? Surah 911 as well. Surah 929.
Chelsea, why are you not
what does Surah 929 say?
So he's talking about Surah Tawbah. Surah Tawbah.
Can you read it, please?
Read it.
Go on.
Allah in the Quran.
Can you read it? We're waiting for you, Shamsi.
Good manners to teach you that if
We're listening. Go on.
So anyone knows that in the Quran, there is some verses which has sebab utanzil. What is sebab utanzil? There is a reason for the verses to be revealed there. Okay? So the verse is verse which is talking about
29.
Tawbah 29.
Yes. Please.
That verse clearly when the Byzantine killed the ambassador.
Evidence. Stop lying. Stop lying.
It's been mentioned.
Evidence.
Bukhari, Ibn Hisham, Ibn Kathir.
Okay, anyone can say that.
With the message of Allah.
Prove it.
Evidence.
Allow me to speak.
No. Evidence. Do you have Ibn Kathir, Ibn Abbas to prove that case? Stop lying. Stop lying.
Okay. Shams, you always do this.
Surah 929 says, fight those who don't believe in Allah.
You don't believe in Allah.
I don't believe in Allah. Jews and Christians. Jews and Christians. That's what the verse says.
Okay. How come there are still Christians and the Jews in Sham, in Syria, Palestine, Morocco, and Egypt? Answer.
Because they don't obey Allah. They don't obey Allah. That's why they don't obey Allah. They are bad Muslims. Bad Muslims. That's why.
After this verse was revealed, do you know who catch the message of Allah? Wafdu Najran. Delegation of Najran came from Yemen.
Explain Surah 29.
After the verse was
you're lying.
I'm speaking Arabic.
You're lying.
Why are you so old?
You are lying.
Why are you lying?
Where is it? Prove it.
You know what, yeah?
Prove it.
The evidence.
I got prove it.
Yeah.
The best Mufti for ISIS, these guys. They are a Mufti. Yeah.
But ISIS say they are Muslims.
No, exactly.
No, no. ISIS claim they are Muslims.
In the Bible said, kill babies and children.
No, but ISIS are good Muslims.
You're
a supporter of Islam. You're a real Muslim.
You have a problem.
You're a supporter of Islam.
Why are you diverting? Why are you diverting, Shamsi? Shamsi's embarrassed. You have to divert. What did he say? What did he say?
They didn't even know what he said. Yeah.
No, 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 what he said. He just said yes.
Okay, donkey.
Why even know?
Allah has no problem with that. Allah has no problem with what he just said. Allah has no problem with that. Problem why you're quoting that.
What about the Spanish and Portuguese
rules? Okay, Shamsi, calm down on the beat.
They're not Christians. But they need to follow Jesus.
What does the Bible say? We need to go with the scriptures.
Okay,
the Quran says you can kill unbelievers. That's what it says.
ISIS are Muslims.
ISIS are Muslims.
ISIS are real Muslims.
ISIS are real Muslims.
ISIS are the followers of Muhammad.
They're followers of Muhammad.
He said ISIS are followers of Bible, you know.
Don't kill children. Don't kill children. Don't kill a woman. Don't kill
ISIS. Call the Quran better than you.
Exactly.
Kill children. Kill a donkey. Allahu Akbar.
Where are you going to go?
Okay.
Where are you going to go? Shamsi.
Don't follow. Shamsi. Come explain to us Surah 929.
Surah 929. Shamsi, can you explain, please?
We need a clear understanding, man.
Shamsi. He runs away as always. Always running away.
I don't think he's cared. I don't think he cares about you anymore, bro.
Doesn't matter about
us. You're not getting views anymore.
It's not about us. It's not about us.
You're not getting views anymore. How do you feel, bro?
No. It's got nothing to do with
it. It's got views, bro.
Who wants explanation? It's got no views,
man. Surah 929, Shamsi.
Who believes? That is okay.
He ran to come here.
In the Bible.
Why did he run?
Kill a baby.
He took two steps and
brought him back on the land. Kill children. That is Samuel 15. Because you believe Jesus is God.
Allah has no problem with that. Why are you quoting that verse?
Why are you shouting in my ear?
Allah has no problem with that.
ISIS are the best friends.
Why are you hitting the Muslim?
Anyway.
See, this is your problem. Everything's a joke. Allah will judge you.
Allah doesn't exist. Allah doesn't exist. Allah is a fake God. He doesn't exist
upon you.
Allah is a devil.
Silence. Exactly.
Silence, burn them. Silence, burn them both.
Oh, Shamsi.
I'm burning, man. I'm burning.
Then the stones will be more expensive than gold. Sometimes that talk back and keep
moving. Yeah, Sahel Bukhari 2711.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Sahel Bukhari 2711. Muhammad said,
I've been made victorious with terror.
Exactly, I've been made victorious with terror.
Is that true,
Shamsi? Is that true, said, don't not kill a woman. Shamsi, is that true? Don't
kill a baby. I've been made victorious with terror.
Is that what he said, Shamsi?
Is that true, Shamsi?
Shamsi, why are you ignoring us?
Are you crazy?
Did he say?
No, we're not. No, because you're contradicting yourself.
Answer the question.
I've been made victorious with terror. Is that true or not?
Yes, is that true?
Let me do coffee.
Yeah, yeah, expose us,
Shamsi. Come on, Shamsi. Why did Muhammad say, I've been made victorious with terror?
Come on.
And Surah 812 as well.
Surah 812.
Why are you not answering the question?
Why are you not answering? Why is there a problem for the woman to be killed? They have no problems for the infant to be slaughtered alive.
Why are you quoting that?
Why are you
writing to the Bible? Why are you writing to the Bible? Why are you running to the Bible? No, we're not. You must be ashamed of the Quran. Allah has no problem with that. I don't know why you're quoting that.
Why are you quoting the Bible when Allah doesn't have a problem with it?
Shamsi. You haven't even answered Surah 929.
So now he's deviating. Huh?
Deviate.
Yeah, you're deviating.
You're somewhere else.
You're deviating.
Why did Allah say he'll be victorious with terror?
Yeah. Why did he say that, Shams?
Why did Muhammad say that?
He's supposed to be the best example to the Makkai.
Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. If you read the history of our beloved Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, by the Orientalists, not Muslims, English American Orientalists, and you compare their speech with some donkeys here, you see clearly who is really sincere and who is really honest.
You're very angry, ain't you, Shamsi?
Now answer the question.
That's why you're insulting. You're very angry, Shamsi. Just answer the question.
Who said you're honest and you're donkey?
Surah 929. Oh, no. Now you're going to lie. All the time he says it.
When he's checking babies and children in the Bible.
So why are you quoting that when we got Surah 929?
Allah has no problem with that.
Shamsi, you're scared. Shamsi, you always run away.
He said, I've been made victorious with terror. Shams, that's what he said.
He's a British citizen. And as a British citizen, you have a contract with the British government. In Islam, it is from a major sin to break your contract.
Prove it.
You're lying.
You are lying again.
I'm not talking about 31. I'm talking about.
You're lying again, Shamsi. You're going against your own God.
Shamsi, why are you lying?
Surah 9, 111. Surah 9, 29. You're going against your own God.
Oofu bil uhud. Oh, you believe? Fulfill your contract.
What contract? Prove it, man. Why are you lying?
No evidence.
ISIS are okay.
No Quranic verses.
ISIS
are Muslims.
ISIS
are not Christians.
ISIS followers of Islam.
No, they follow you.
Are they Muslims?
They're not Muslims. They're not Muslims. You're scared. Look at him, man.
Hey, listen to this, brothers, sisters, ladies and gentlemen. Let us read ISIS, the push passage they follow. Now go, attack the Malachites, and totally destroy all that
Muhammad
belongs to them.
Muhammad said, I'll be made victorious.
The Bible, the Bible.
Is that true, Shamsi?
What has the Amalekites got to do with today? Shamsi, what has the Amalekites got to do with today? There are no Amalekites today. Today, as a Muslim, you're supposed to kill unbelievers. As a Christian, I'm not.
Answer a question, Shamsi.
Shamsi, you're desperate.
Exactly.
Go back to the point.
Christian, do not have mercy on Malachite.
Why is it ISIS always quote the Quran?
Their children.
Exactly.
Why did they quote the Quran?
Why did they quote the Quran?
Why did the ISIS quote the Quran?
Allah has no problem with that.
They're gonna say, Shazi, thank you for answering. Harassing me.
Shazi,
no one's harassing me.
You're kind of sponsored by Christians anyway.
Hey, answer that question.
Why didn't you answer the question? You're just a cameraman, isn't it? Sad. Muslims run away again. What happened on Friday? We asked them. Surah 929,
yeah.
Surah 911, confirms that you can fight and kill unbelievers. There's no war getting involved. And they can go to paradise when they kill and being killed in the name of Allah.
Right. And what he keeps doing, he keeps using ISIS to
ISIS are Christians.
Yeah, they're Christians, and he says that they quote, or he starts to quote from the Bible. But if you look at what ISIS quote, they quote the Quran.
Exactly.
They give an explanation for why they do what they're doing. They don't pick these things out of random air and say, well, we're just doing this because we feel like going on a heist and murdering innocent people. No, they do it because this is what the Quran teaches. This is what is solidified and confirmed and affirmed in their hadiths and in their sources. This is what the true teachings of their Prophet Muhammad explains and commands for Muslims to do. So the true Muslims are ISIS, not these wannabe run around dawah gangs in
Spanish.
The real ones are the ones who are actually going over
there. If you want to be a true Muslim, follow ISIS.
Exactly.
Oh, Muhammad.
So what we say is, be a true Christian, be a true follower of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Follow Jesus Christ. He said, love your enemies, bless those who curse you, do good to those who despitefully use you.
That's
a true example. Pray for them. You know?
He's the Prince of Prince. He's the Prince of Peace.
Amen.
Peace.
Hallelujah.
Jesus Christ.
Yes.
He sets you free. God bless you.
God bless you.